soaked, like it was soaked with blood. It was soaked with blood. So no, and it's your mouth just feel very heavy.
Yeah,
it's so uncomfortable.
And like so much blood. Like when I see that seat, like so much blood. I kept spitting blood.
Button and click that thumbs up button.
Well, today we have a very special person with us. She's the latest Lynx graduating class nursing student, TONI.
Hi.
So happy to have her here, and trust me, we have something very, very, very exciting for you guys today. Stay tuned. Don't go anywhere.
So, first question, why did you have to remove your teeth? Okay, I felt pain in February, mm-hmm. and I was on clinicals then, so I thought it was just something minor. So I came back home because of the pandemic and stuff. Mm-hmm. So I was at home for, I've been at home since February, sorry. The pain was still there. I tried taking ice, it reduced, and then I thought, oh, maybe it was because my molar was just growing, was going to go away. Mm-hmm. And then with time, a month, 2 months, it was still not going. And I could not eat my chin chin, my comfort, and everything. So I was like, okay, let me just go and see the dentist. They'll most probably give me a pain reliever, mm-hmm. and then to go away. And I just went there, you know, he examined it and was like, go for an x-ray. So I went, and then the guy that was taking the x-ray was just shaking his head.
Oh no!
And I was wondering maybe it's just minor, maybe it's just something minor. Then I got there, and he was seriously looking at the x-ray, and I'm like, I'm done for. And I was like, sorry, we have to take it out. So from what I saw, instead of the molar to grow straight, like it grows, instead of it to grow normally, mm-hmm. it was slanting. So it was entering into my mandible, into my jawbone. Ooh. And it was like, well, we have to take it off. And then we also have to take the corresponding one up. So that was how they took two
at once. Wait, the molar is also called wisdom teeth, right?
Yes.
A lot of people don't know that. Like I was saying, I have to take out my wisdom teeth. People don't know what wisdom teeth. So you can just, I should just say maybe molar, mm-hmm. my molar teeth. Yes. So yeah, same thing. Funny thing is, I don't think mine was as serious as yours. Like, mine wasn't as urgent, but it was causing me like pain and discomfort.
It's very
painful when it's growing. I don't know how some of you, it's like maybe some people don't feel pain or something. Mm-hmm. I don't understand. But like, I left it for a long time. I decided not to remove it, but at some point, I said, let me just remove this thing. So it's going to cause me future problems. Like, it was just too much. So that's why I removed my teeth.
Second question. So the next question is, was it painful?
Hey! Wow. Okay, first of all, when you go to remove your teeth, like, there's this needle that they would inject. Is it anesthesia or something?
Yes.
Yes. In order to like make that place numb, so when they're removing the teeth, like you wouldn't feel it. But that needle is like this long, and they will put it like all the way into your gum, so you feel it.
Oh my god.
So it was painful when they were putting that needle in to like inject the anesthesia into my mouth, and they did it like multiple times because I wasn't getting enough quickly enough. It was,
you
too.
Yeah. And it was just, you know, it's not just one part they inject. They have to inject the whole area.
Yes.
Remove.
That was already the first part of the pain. I didn't feel the pain when they were taking out the teeth though. I didn't really feel much pain. I felt like something, but it wasn't pain. But after,
severe pain.
How about you? Was it painful for you?
Well, yeah, the anesthesia was painful. You know, when he was injecting, and I was like, "Are you not done? Please remove this thing."
So after that, it took a while for me, for my cheeks and then everything to get numb.
Mm-hmm.
And then afterwards, I don't know, it took some time for them to take out the one down.
They like jacked that.
Yes. So he came before the second time it was about to come out, but because of the roots, it was almost in bone. So as it was about to, I was like, I can't feel it. Mm-mm. I can't. So he stopped again, injected again. So that part was painful.
I have mercy. How about after?
After, it was not really painful. Well, before I left, the anesthesia was wearing off.
Mm-hmm.
And then I was like, I'm not going to leave this place. He has to give me an injection. And I'm a nurse, so I know
exactly.
What's part of removing your teeth?
Wow, okay. The worst part of removing my teeth was the fact that I couldn't eat the food that I so love eating. Like, the temptation was much. My sister was so happy because she got to eat those things that I wasn't able to eat. That was the worst part. And also, for me, I don't know if Tony went through this, but like, after, because you know they put the anesthesia to make our mouth like numb, mm-hmm. and like a certain part of our mouth, like half this side, where they were taking out the teeth. And after the surgery, I was thinking maybe the numbness would wear off. But yeah, up to like, even to now, even to now, it's still a little bit numb. But like, it was really bad. The numbness was still there. I wasn't able to taste anything. Like half of my tongue was like basically dead. And in the night, I would get like a tingling sensation. It was very uncomfortable. It was very, very, very uncomfortable. So that, plus the fact that I wasn't able to eat well, and my face looked like a watermelon, was like the worst. That was the worst part of this whole experience for me. How about you?
Mine too was not being able to eat well. But let me expand shit on that. The other part is being able to communicate.
Yes, that's true.
You'll be trying to say something.
I couldn't forget.
And then people don't understand what you're saying. But you're trying to talk, and then it's just a fact.
Right?
Sometimes you have to like write, like, this is what I mean.
But it's not what making fun of me. Don't just be saying sorry.
And then when you have calls, so you're not able to pick you.
Yeah,
you have to text, like, sorry, I can't talk.
I can't
now.
Talk.
Can you
text
me?
I did that
me?
So many times.
Okay, the best part of removing the teeth. What was the best part?
Being able to eat.
Yes.
After.
I love the food.
All the chin chin, cornflakes, what
types too?
Fried plantain. What else is hard again? All the foods that are crunchy. Yeah. Granola,
yeah.
To eat everything.
Chicken.
With so much joy, without pain, and chicken, fish, everything. KFC, you can eat everything.
I think the best part of this for me was the fact that, like, I think it taught me like how to be patient, mm-hmm. and it taught me a lot of self-control because, hey, not having to talk was difficult for me. Not being able to eat the way I wanted was difficult for me, and I just appreciated God because I'm like, something as small as this can like have such a great impact on the whole body. Like, it's just amazing. I think that was the best part for me. That realization I came to. So what were some post-surgery instructions?
You're gonna gurgle.
I don't like
salt,
that part.
Hot salt water. Yeah. Hot
that's
water.
Nice.
Okay, let me just say warm water. Let me say hot.
Yeah.
So that you don't go and taste. Warm water with salt.
Yes.
When you wake up. Before breakfast. After breakfast. Before lunch. After lunch. Before supper. After supper. Before you go to bed.
Man, I'm not even gonna lie. I did it like 4 times. Maybe 4 to 6. At least 6 times. At most 6 times.
I wasn't
not
faithful.
I wasn't. But please don't be like us though. It's not just that. Other instructions, even food. There's some food that I said we shouldn't eat. Man,
don't eat anything too hot. And then you have to wait. You know, when you make food, you are hungry, you want it immediately, you have to wait for it to get cold. Though I actually took a lot of cold food,
mm-hmm.
and so mine didn't really swell and it was not so painful.
Yeah.
But then for swallow, they asked us to take swallows and then liquid and
mm-hmm.
diet. But for swallow, I am not used to swallowing. I'm used to chewing. So swallowing, you know, you just have to take a, you have to take very little. Mm-hmm. So you, it's not getting uncomfortable in your throat. It's a recovery been so far. And then what advice do you have to those who want to take out their wisdom tooth?
Okay, first of all, advice. Don't do it. Don't run.
I'm just joking. But like, if your situation was as urgent as Tony's, I think it's better to take it out so it wouldn't cause you like future complications and problems. Yeah. However, I feel like, because there are people who don't take out their wisdom teeth, if you can enjoy the pain for some time and you know it's not causing you too much problem, they don't have to take it out. But if you do need to take it out, you should take it out.
I love you too.
But recovery for me, it's been like what, a month now, I think. Like about a month, and for me recovery has been okay. I can eat pretty much anything now, so that's good. And my mouth has gone, like the swelling has gone down, but in terms of, like I mentioned, the numbness is still there a little bit, and I still can't really taste things. They all, like in terms, like when I eat something pepperish, like that part is extra pepperish, that side. Yeah, but other than that, I'm okay. I'm good.
It's been okay, just that once in a while you just feel like there's something missing there, and then sometimes you just find your tongue going there trying to
you're looking for the missing piece
yes, yes. And then sometimes the way you laugh, sometimes like your cheek is going it's going in. But other than that, it's been very okay, no pain. And then it's now comfortable. At least When the pain was there, it was just uncomfortable.
Very, very, very uncomfortable.
But now, it's better. And then my advice to you, if you have to take out your wisdom, no, let me see. If you have to take out any of your teeth or tooth, please see the dentist.
Yes.
Let them guide you, direct you. Okay, you have to take it out. Or okay, it's just growing, or maybe it's the process it takes to grow. Just see the dentist, they will have a better say on it.
Okay guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe, click that thumbs up button, and comment below. Let us know if you've had any similar experience, how it was for you, if you had to maybe remove your wisdom teeth at some point, or any teeth. Just let us know how it was, and if you can relate, if you can't relate, you know. I'm really, really happy to have you on here. Thank you so much for making time.
It was fun, kids.
Yeah.